This is Today in the Bay.
Time now, 7:52. The next time you drink a cup of coffee from Starbucks or Peet's, you might think about it differently after hearing from some Stanford business students. Their Silicon Valley startup hopes to revolutionize the gourmet specialty coffee business. We're going to talk about how they're doing it with a company called Farm to Cup. Monica Lewis and Katha Mullen are here from Stanford bright and early with us this morning. Thanks for joining us, ladies.
Thanks for having us in.
Yeah. So you went to a coffee farm in Guatemala, and it really changed your mindset and also inspired Farm to Cup. Talk to us about the mission of your organization.
Yeah, so our mission is really to try to transform the way the coffee gets from the farm to your doorstep. We are basically just using the internet to try to cut out a lot of the middlemen that currently crowd the coffee supply chain so that you can get a more direct connection with the farmer and you can get better, fresher coffee. And in the process, since we're cutting out all these middlemen, the farmers get a lot more value from that.
Okay, very good. How do consumers benefit then directly from this?
Well, so theoretically, we can offer coffee cheaper to consumers because the value that was previously going to a lot of middlemen can now be split between the farmer and the consumer. So this is a benefit to consumers.
Okay, so you cut out the middlemen. And this, you know, you're starting on a small scale, but eventually you have big dreams to kind of change the way coffee is bought mainstream with, say, big chains that we're familiar with, like Starbucks and Peet's.
Yeah. Well, yes, our vision is to create an online marketplace, like a farmer's market for coffee. And we hope that this direct channel where farmers can sell their coffee directly to consumers will actually put some pressure on corporations like Starbucks and Peet's, which are actually already starting to do more sustainable sourcing. So they're trying to start to go directly to the farmers as well. This is a movement that we are
just pushing it one step forward, really.
Yes.
Okay, very good. So while you're building your business, you're still students, right? So while you're building this, what can we do to kind of support this kind of movement?
I think what's exciting for us is just encouraging consumers to ask more about where their products are coming from and the impact it's having along the way. So it's more than just buying our coffee, it's really demanding more knowledge and being more responsible and realizing that actually when you spend a dollar, you're kind of voting, you're saying what you care about and what your values are.
Okay, very good. I'm gonna take a sip of the coffee you run and thanks for bringing in a sample. So does that mean looking for fair trade on the label, you know, when you're making that decision of what you're gonna buy?
Well, so a consumer can educate themselves on what it means to be fair trade. Fair trade, there are a number of different certifications in coffee: Rainforest Alliance, Fair Trade. Starbucks has its own certification, and just to educate themselves on what each of those mean. It actually gets a little bit complicated, so we're trying to offer an easier alternative. Just buy direct from the farmer. You know where it's coming from. You know where the money is going when you're purchasing.
Awesome. Thank you. We really appreciate it. Monica and Katha, we appreciate your time this morning. To learn more about the effort, there's a website. It's called farmcup.com. And thanks so much for joining us this morning. And this is delicious, by the way.
Thank you.
Still ahead on Today in the Bay, Battle of the Bay, a preseason game with the Niners hosting the Raiders tonight. Coming up, a friendly wager between the city mayors, what they have riding on the outcome of the game.